It's time for another fine comedian. Go wild and crazy for Pete Johansson!
How's it going?
Wow, feel that energy. You guys are on fire. I'm Canadian. I don't know if anybody cares. Probably not. Yeah. Hey, that's the most reaction I've ever gotten from that. That's awesome. It's weird being Canadian in the UK because nobody knows what to say to us because we don't get a lot of legacy or anything like that. The best I get over here is a, hey, you guys are a lot like Australians. And I'm like, not really. I'm pretty sure my ancestors had a choice to move to Canada. I'm getting old. Look around all the young people in here. You're so sweet and young. Except for you. How old are you? Wow. You like 40s? Up. Oh, ticket, 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 death. Welcome down. It's weird getting old. I'm 36. There's so much weird shit happening to me. It's freaking me out. Oh, my God. Nobody prepared me for aging. It's weird because they prepare you when you're young. When you're a little kid, they show you movies in school for the changes your body goes through. But nobody shows you movies for the shit that happens when you're 30. I would have loved to see a movie about, like, just my balls. Oh, my God. My balls took off down my leg like a couple of mice chasing after some cheese in my shoes. Oh, my God. My left ball took a good half-inch lead on my right ball. So I got this offset grandfather clock of balls going on. Which, by the way, is good evolution, because now when I jog, they don't hit each other. That's refreshing. I hate big balls. I want tiny balls. Little balls. You're a young guy. You probably got little robin's eggs balls. Yay! Enjoy little balls. Little balls are great because you don't think about them. I'm always thinking about my big balls. Always. Every time I cross my legs, I got to make a choice. Tuck under, flip over. I got to make a choice. I can't drop down on a hard bench anymore. I gotta lower that last 3 inches out of precaution. You just catch the tip of a ball and you don't know it for 15 seconds and... Sex was so much better with little balls, too. Oh, I don't want to be graphic, but little balls. You don't prepare with your little balls. You just get right in there and go as fast as you want. Wee, yay, get it over quick before she changes her mind. Yay! Big balls participate. They're involved. They're swinging along with you. They got a built-in speed limit. I can't go as fast as him. I can go as fast as I can take the pain of impact on the end of the stroke. And I had to learn rhythm. I never had rhythm when I was younger. It's all, now I'm smooth. You got no choice with a big sack swinging along with you. You try and change speeds, they get confused. You'll start pulling out, they'll wrap around her legs, pull you in for another one. Canadians talk about their balls a lot. I'm getting fat too as I get older. I hate that. I don't want to be fat. So I work out. I work out 4 times a week right now just to maintain the shitty body that I have. I don't make any progress. I just accepted the fact I'm gonna be fat. Oh, I'm gonna be fat. You just know you're gonna be fat. I looked at my parents. My mom's fat. My dad's fat. I'm from North America. That's 3 strikes. You're fat. And I'm not gonna be kind of fat. I'm gonna be fat. I'm gonna be huge fat. I'm gonna be on a motorized scooter in Asda knocking donuts into my tray with a cane. Fat. I don't want it to happen now, so I work out at my gym. Work out as best I can. I work out at a gay gym. I don't know if that's weird. I'm not gay. I'm actually very supportive of gays because my oldest brother's probably gay. Well, he's never told me he's gay, but I kind of put it together, you know? He's lived in the same 2-bedroom flat with the same guy for the last 10 years. 1 bedroom's an office. But he won't come out of the closet because my big fat parents are big fat Catholic parents, and they don't like gays. They're actually, an actual quote from my dad is, the legalization of gay marriage is the cause for forest fires. That's a fact. So I don't want to be like him, so I'm very liberal. I challenge myself to be liberal, open-minded. I never want to judge somebody because of their culture, creed, religion, or gender orientation. But it's funny, as hard as I try to be the most liberal person I possibly can, I still have this little tiny redneck. This little insensitive redneck that lives right at the base of my brain. And he doesn't control my movements or my actions, but he talks to me. And one of those places where my little redneck still loses it is when I go into the shower at the gay gym. I know, I'm shocked as you are. As soon as I go in there, my little redneck loses it. He goes, what are you doing? I'm gonna go have a shower. You don't want a shower here. I go, why's that, little redneck? And he says it clear as day in a trembling, fearful voice. He goes, because you don't want to be stared at by gay guys. I'm like, oh my God, am I that person still? And I am. But you know what I've learned by challenging my values, by going back again and again and making myself go to the gay shower? I've learned that there's something way worse than being stared at by gay guys. and that's not being stared at by gay guys. Holy shit, does that suck? Like, really? Nobody's into me? What the fuck is wrong with me? I dance around that shower like a tart now trying to get attention. I'm dropping shit, I'm backing into guys, I'm eating bananas in the corner. That's when you know you have a shitty body, when you can't spark a boner in a gay shower, my friends. Folks, you guys have been great. My name's Pete Johansson. Thank you very much.
Pete Johansson!